Hello, Emmaus family and friends of Emmaus as well. I have gone to the glasses here as I will be reading some notes that I'll use to guide me. And I want to give you this warning as well. I have tried to find a quiet corner in the house, but the family is in a loud mood and perhaps we'll be hearing them behind me. We'll see. I wanted to post this video to provide an update and share my heart with you regarding the approach Emmaus will be taking when it comes to re-entry into the sanctuary for gathered worship services on Sunday. As you can imagine, it's a complex issue with a lot of factors to it. There are many legitimate concerns that have already been shared, and I know that there are strong, valid feelings that people have when it comes to this matter. And I want you to know that the leadership at Emmaus takes these matters to heart. We value the concerns that have been shared, and we want to thank you for your involvement and your care for our church. Okay, while the governor has allowed for indoor, in-person worship gatherings, Emmaus will not be offering such gatherings at this time. Furthermore, we do not, at this time, have a definitive timeline for when we will offer in-person gatherings in the sanctuary for worship. I know that an announcement like this brings about varying degrees of relief, but also disappointment, maybe both. We miss each other, we want to be together, and this is a good thing. But we want to make sure that any plan, any phased plan that we implement when it comes to getting back into the sanctuary together takes in a number of considerations and is done in the right way. So how are we moving forward? We won't just be sitting on our hands. There are important factors that we will be looking to and that will inform us in how we might phase back into re-entry into the sanctuary together. For example, we will continue to seek out the guidance of health officials on the risk that large indoor gatherings might pose to our community and to our health facilities in our community. We want to play our part in not contributing to another shutdown, so the guidance of officials and data will be important. Another factor that we want to make sure that we are properly is that we are properly prepared as a church for gathering together again in that way. From the start of this crisis, we have committed ourselves to the guidelines provided by the Minnesota Department of Health and the CDC. We will continue with that commitment. As of today, the guidelines from the Minnesota Department of Health for churches re-entering into sanctuary spaces, it's a 12-page document. So as you can imagine, we do have some work to do, and we're committed to making sure we're prepared in complying with these guidelines. Another thing we want to take care of is that we are be informed and think about the responses of surrounding organizations in our community, especially other churches. I can tell you that in the past 4 days, I have had a number of conversations with fellow pastors and who serve in Northfield and in our community. And I can tell you that based on these conversations, the churches represented by those pastors, none of them have a definitive date by which they will be gathering together in their buildings. In fact, they don't have a timeline either. They want to make sure that they do it slowly and they do it safely. And so I want you to know that the approach we are taking at Emmaus, while it might be slightly different than other churches, we're not alone in the ways we're moving forward on this. So that represents some of the considerations, benchmarks, if you will, that we will be using as we progress towards re-entry. We may not have a timeline, but there are some things we do know. For example, we know that whenever the building is open again for services, our church services will look very different than they did before the crisis. Numbers will be limited. Our worship practices will be altered. Services will be no-touch events, at least for a time, and participants will be asked to abide by certain requirements. And this will take some getting used to. I know that some of these changes will not be everyone's preference, but we will make these changes for the safety of our brothers and sisters and our guests, but we will also do so to demonstrate kindness and care for the concerns of others. And that's a biblical value, right? I know that changes like that, like this, may cause some to choose not to participate, and I can understand that. Another thing that we know is that our Sunday service live streams have become a vital part of our life together as a church. And I want to say and make clear yet again that we fully intend to continue with these live stream and recorded services even after we might gather together in person in our sanctuary. There are no plans to stop offering the live stream. So, rest assured, if you hope to continue to have access to live stream and recorded services, they will continue to be available. We also know that it has been very difficult on us not to meet together as a church. This crisis has presented all kinds of difficulties, and one of those is that we're not meeting in person together. It's been hard on me, I can tell you that. So our staff and leadership, we're working on possible ways that we might be able to safely and responsibly have in-person connection in the coming weeks or months. They will not be large indoor gatherings, and we will value and comply with Minnesota Department of Health guidelines, but our hope is that we might be able to phase in some low-risk, safe options over the summer. This has been said before, but I want to say it again. When the time comes for us to re-enter into the sanctuary together for worship services, it will not be us going back to church. It will be the church going back to the building. We are the church, you and me, wherever we are. During this stay at home time, one thing that the Lord has done in my heart is to remind me and challenge me what faith and church is truly all about. And it's about Jesus and the love of Jesus. We are to be ambassadors of Christ. And yes, we gather together. And then we do that, and then we go back out into our lives and we share the good news and the love of Jesus being his hands and his feet. May the grace and the peace of Jesus surround you on every side. Thank you for watching. We will continue to keep you updated. And know that as your pastor, I love you. Have a great day.